historical interests on Berry Head are the two forts we've got. So these forts are about 200 years old, well, a little bit less, but around about 200 years old, so it's quite old. This building is the guardhouse. And again, this guardhouse was built over 190 years ago. So there's not very much left of it, but that's not just because of how old it is, but because when everyone in Brixton wanted a new house, they used to come up here and take bits off it. So this is the magazine. What are they keeping there? Everyone.
Gunpowder,
right. So you see, it's also situated right next to the guardhouse. Because there'd always be men around here to help protect it. Probably somebody who'd been stationed outside as well. Alright? This is a type of stone called limestone. And in a moment, when we got to the other fort, I'll show you where this stone came from. This is a stone called granite. Now, have any of you ever heard of Dartmoor? Yeah? That's what Dartmoor's made of, granite. So this stone actually came from Dartmoor. So I want you to count how many gun slits there are, okay? Show you what a gun crew would have done. Now, got the loader, please. Step to the front of the cannon. Now, the loader would have loaded in the gunpowder and the cannonball, and then step back. Now, can I have the rammer, please? Now, the rammer would have had a big, long stick with a big rammer on the end, and she would have rammed the gunpowder and the ball in. Rammed in?
Yeah.
Right then, we'll step back. Now, can I have the aimer, please? The aimer would have stood at the back of the cannon, looked along the length of the cannon to see it was pointing at the enemies.
Go on.
Yep. No, you just aim it. And then the firer would be stood back with a long stick that was burning at one end and would have touched it to the top. Now, on the top, there would have either been a long piece of string going down into the gunpowder, or more likely, just a hole. And he would have tapped the hole, and a spark would have gone down and set fire to the gunpowder. So the loader would set the charge off with the stick. Loader, set the charge off.
Fire
it. Slide backwards. Ooh. To here. Again, this bridge would have been a drawbridge. And what wasn't in the moat?
Water.
Water. What was in the moat?
Spikes and entanglements.
So, entanglement, would have been sort of like a
helmet.
Something you get tangled up with, that's right. Now again, you can see some iron things. They were the remains of the drawer where the drawbridge was tied to.
So,
that seagull just caught a fish. And there. So, we're able to move the camera. I can left to right, like this. And also, up and down, like that. Brilliant, what a windscreen wiper. A rainy day, just like today. So we can wipe the water off the legs. What do you think gulls eat then? Peanut butter sandwiches?
Yeah.
Egg and chips?
The scavengers.
They're scavengers, yes.
All kinds.
All kinds, that's right. They eat
fish.
Dead fish, yeah. They don't actually kill fish.
Crabs.
Yeah, crabs on the beach.
Like if someone was probably just eating a sandwich and they
And it was crumbling and it crumbled.
That's right. They'll eat absolutely anything. But during the summer months, their favourite food becomes other birds' eggs. Right, now if we look at some of the seabirds we have here. Can zoom in. A member of the auk family, a close relative of the puffin. You all know what puffins are, don't you?
Yeah.
You've all seen them, black and white, big beak, yellow, black, yellow,
red
and blue on the beak. So these are a cousin of the puffin.
Thank you. chance.
What's this? 65
you know.
packed lunches.